Sheldon joins us live now. We're going to find out from the deck of the Brazilian tall ship, Donna, help me.
Much respect, Sheldon. The Cisne Branco.
Much better. Hello, Sheldon.
Hey, Jeff, how are you? I earned my keep. I want to let you guys know that. Being a sailor, sure, they get to see all of these different cities and they get to travel around, but it is a lot of hard work. And while we were traveling up to Baltimore, I tried my hand at some of those chores. So promise me you will not laugh. Before a naval officer or enlisted member can even get an interview to work on the Cisne Branco, they have to climb this 150-foot mast. Since we were honorary crew members for this voyage, I decided to give it a try. I got butterflies in my stomach and I'm shaking, but we'll see what happens.
One leg here and another.
You know what you're doing, so I'm putting my life in your hands. All right. Strapped in, got these on to protect my palms so I don't get tired or calloused or cut up on the way up or on the way down. After a brief tutorial from my trusted officer, I was off. Well, almost.
Should I go in the middle or should I go on the side?
I'm not usually afraid of heights, but it's hard to balance yourself on a rope ladder while trying to climb it at the same time. Not to mention the fact that your legs aren't steady.
I was told not to look down.
Should I look down? Huh?
Very high up. A little nervous. I'm very high up compared to you right now, but this comes the tricky part, trying to get onto the platform up here. So. I'm harnessed in. We'll see what happens. So far, so good.
After a quick pep talk from my guides and some last-minute instruction, I was happy to finally reach my destination, and the views were breathtaking. I feel pretty accomplished for making it to the halfway point. Now the tough part is, I guess, making my way down this 60-foot climb. Despite some friendly heckling from the deck,
what other chance in your life are you going to have to do it?
I couldn't be convinced to climb the remaining 90 feet.
I was going to attempt to go to the top one, but I think I'm just going to call it a day and make my way back down to the deck.
Coming back down was a little bit harder than it looks, but Slow and Steady won this race.
Here, let him go. Let him go between us.
And I was relieved to be back on the deck. All right.
Well done. Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay. All right, so I can cross that off the list that I climbed up a mast on a tall ship in the middle of the Chesapeake. How many people can say they did that? So, patting myself on the back for that.
But my efforts to fit in with the crew didn't stop there. Next, I tried my hand at steering the ship by being the helmsman.
Keeping the course at 340. Okay. So, at this time right now, it's being very easy to be the helmsman.
All right, so what happens if I move this a little bit?
My ship, no.
I eventually corrected our path and was even offered the graveyard shift. But for many of these sailors, steering the ship, cleaning the boat, or climbing the mast isn't as hard as juggling other aspects of life at sea.
We love traveling. The difficult part is being away so long from our families.
Very pleasant to just, you know, sail. We got beautiful view, beautiful sunset. We got a lot of hard work here too, but at the end of everything, it's very, very nice, very pleasant.
And you do have to remember that a lot of these guys are away from their families from 5 to 7 months out of the year, depending on their deployments and where they get assigned. The crew here that traveled with the Cisne Branco to Baltimore left Brazil in March, and they've been traveling up the United States and around the world from there. But one of the crew members that we talked to, one of the officers actually, he talked a lot about his wife and his young son. And today when we docked here at the Inner Harbor, his wife was waiting and so was his young son, and he brought them on the ship, and it's just touching to see that reunion. She traveled up to New York to see him, but when he held his son and like he gave his wife a kiss, definitely very touching, and he introduced them to us, which meant a lot to us because he was our buddy while we were traveling. Gonna toss it back to you guys over on top of the Science Center.
Hey Sheldon, I know you were telling me that that a number of the wives of the sailors of the Cisne Branco are actually in town.
Yeah,
not just that one.
Yes, exactly. They spent about 7 days in New York for Fleet Week. So a lot of the wives came up from Brazil to New York to spend time with their husbands. I just want to pass on a quick note, though, that this entire crew is all male. They do have women in the Navy in Brazil, but this particular ship, whenever they're going out to sea, it's only men. So a lot of the wives and the girlfriends came to New York to celebrate Fleet Week with their husbands because they had a week. And then a few came down here to Baltimore.
Nice.
All right, Sheldon Dutez, one of the daredevil reporters from WBAL-TV 11.